Good morning, lower school. I am Mrs. Grumble, the professional crumble maker, and I've been invited onto your version of the great lower school bake-off today to make Gruffalo Crumble. Now, I'm really excited because I've heard that this is the greatest new recipe on the scene. So you're also going to be making Gruffalo Crumble with me. There are a few things that you're going to need. I'd like you to grab, if you can, and if you don't have any of these items, don't worry, you can just use your imagination. If you've got a rolling pin, fantastic, grab the rolling pin. If you've got yourself a wooden spoon, grab one of them too. A nice mixing bowl, and then obviously we need something to put our crumble in as well. Or also, as a bonus, if you've got a juicer, there's some lovely juice we're going to be putting in to our Gruffalo crumble today. So there we go. As a recap, I'm going to just introduce the show again. Welcome to the great lower school bake-off, the Gruffalo edition. Remember your rolling pin, your lovely wooden spoon, your bowl, your crumble pan, and juicer. Hello, lower school. It's day one in the Gruffalo bake-off tent, and our technical challenge today is to make Gruffalo crumble. Your job is to follow along to make the best crumble we can, and also to see if later on in the quiz you can remember some things about the ingredients that we use in our crumble today. So, step one, you will need your mixing bowl and wooden spoon. Okay, the first ingredient we are going to put in is some fox butter. So you just need to take your cup and just give it a little chop up, chop it up into cubes, that's it, nice cubes of fox butter. Put the fox butter in and just mash it up a bit with the spoon, that's it, mash it up a little bit. There we go. The next thing we need is some owl sugar. Now this sugar is special sugar that has come from owls transporting it in their beaks from one place to the other, grabbing up delicious pollen and delicious things on the way. So we're going to put some owl sugar in. Just pour your sugar in. There we go. Nice, but it's quite a sweet one, this. You need lots of sweet things to balance out the real disgusting things that are coming later. So really pour that sugar in. And again, just cream it with the butter. Looking good. Okay, next we have got some snake flour. Now, the snake flour has just come from the scaly bits of the snake. It's a bit unpleasant, but it's really, really good in a crumble. So just pop in your flour. Oof, got a bit on the nose then. Just be careful not to get any on your nose. All right, and then we're going to stir it up. It's starting to get a really nice mixture now. Now, it might go a bit green because of the snake flour, but don't worry about that. Okay, big stir. Great, so we've had our fox butter, we've had our owl sugar, and we've had our snake flour. The next thing, okay, this is where it gets really interesting with specialist ingredients. This is what the judges are going to really be judging you on. So we've got some knee nobbles. Now, if you look, if you take them out of the packet, they're like little nobbles of bread, but they're just nobbly knees from the Gruffalos. So just break the nobbles in. That's it, break in the nobbles. Okay, and just give that a little stir. All right. The next thing is a little bit strange. It's essence of poisonous wort. So it's just a little kind of bottle like that. I'm going to take the pipette and drop the essence of poisonous wort in. 3 drops of that, and that doesn't need much of a stir. That's fine. Okay, next thing we've got our bowl of orange eyes. Now, as you can see, they're merely for decoration later. So there's lots of orange eyes there. If you pick one up, you can squidge it. Not very nice. But there's your bowl of orange eyes. I'm going to just pop them to the side, but we are going to take one of the eyes, okay, and we're going to get our lemon squeezer and just squeeze it on, oh, because we're going to get some of the juice from that eye and pop it into our Gruffalo crumble. Okay, and it should just come out. There we go. There we go. All right, it tastes better than it looks, I can guarantee. Okay, next we're going to get some purple prickle sprinkles, okay, so just sprinkle that in there, and it really adds an interesting flavour. And we're also going to, we've got to get our slices of bread. So I'm just going to get my rolling pin now. And you're just going to get your slices of bread, because this is what the Gruffalo wanted the mouse on a slice of bread, do you remember? Get your slice of bread and just roll it so it's really thin. I know this seems a bit weird, really roll out the bread, really go, really get your elbows in. Okay, and then, and strangely enough, we're then going to just take up your sheet of rolled out bread and just break it in. I know that's a weird thing to do, but just break the bits in. Okay, I just wanted it kind of in tiny little thin pieces. And just give it a really big stir, big stir. Okay, now it comes for the star ingredients. We're gonna go back the way we came, if that makes sense. So if you think about it, we've made our big Gruffalo crumble, but we're going to go back and visit the other people and see if we can get their star ingredients. So the first person the Gruffalo and the mouse see is, who is it? It's the snake. So the snake, actually, you know, we're gonna put some scrambled snake in. So get your bowl, here's one I made earlier, of scrambled snake, pop the scrambled snake in, really give it a stir. The next thing, it's owl ice cream, isn't it? Pop the owl ice cream in, and the cone as well. Break up the cone, give it a stir. Really, it's getting really whippy now. You're gonna have to really, really go for it. Yeah, really give it a stir. And then finally, we've got our tray here of roasted fox. And again, I'm just gonna sort of bash it a little bit with my rolling pin, just to smoosh it up a bit. Okay, and then just sort of let that roasted fox go in. It looks a bit like sweet potato roasted fox, a bit strange really. All right, and again, give it a stir. Those are our star ingredients. And to finish off, we've got the mouse's favourite, which is nuts. If you remember at the end of the story, the mouse found a nut and the nut looked good. We've got a lot of nuts here. We've got a bag of nuts. So just pour your nuts, chop nuts in. Save some for the top of the crumble. All right, ready to go in. So get your crumble dish now and you're going to pour in the mixture. Ooh, look at that Gruffalo crumble delight. And then we're going to just sprinkle the rest of the nuts on top. The mouse nuts, there we go. And there we have it, the Gruffalo crumble ready to go in the oven. And later on, maybe, just maybe, there'll be someone to judge which class had the best crumble. Did L1 have the best crumble? Did L2 have the best crumble? Did L3 have the best crumble? Did L4 have the best crumble? Or did L5 have the best crumble? What I'd love you to do is to send some videos or photographs in of you making your Gruffalo crumble so I can see who maybe had the best crumble. Well done, lower school. That was your Gruffalo crumble bake-off with me, Mrs. Grumble, professional crumble maker.